I'm sure many of you have had this experience at least once. Hey, I've been in this moment before, or even further, I've been in this moment again, and I know what will happen next.
Oh, déjà vu.
Yes. As probably everyone who watched this video knows, and Neon said, the name given to this feeling is déjà vu. Whenever you experience déjà vu, you may have been under the influence for a few minutes, and asked yourself questions like, what is déjà vu, and why did I experience such a feeling? Some of us may have even attributed it to reincarnation, clairvoyance, or that it was a simulation error, just like in the movie The Matrix. Of course, although these are exaggerated and evidence-free thoughts, it is normal for us to think like this in a way because we do not know the reasons. At least with this video, you can get some information, look at the details of the subject, what real science says, and some research results.
What is it?
A déjà vu is usually a glitch in the matrix. It happens when they change something.
Déjà vu is French for already seen, and refers to the state of feeling that you have already seen or experienced an event that you are currently seeing or experiencing. As a result of the researches, it is known that 2 out of every 3 people experience déjà vu, and it is more common in their 20s than in older ages. On the other hand, it is also said that the probability is not only related to the age factor, but also that people who travel and people with many different memories are more likely to experience déjà vu. Even much earlier, such as in the 5th century, St. Augustine described it as false memories. Since then, many scientists have focused on different aspects of this subject, and thanks to a series of science fiction movies, especially the Matrix movie, the subject has become even more intriguing for today's people. If we start from this curiosity and research, we don't need to go back to very distant histories. For example, Edward Titchener made this kind of statement about déjà vu in 1928. Before the brain produces a complete perception of an experience, it creates a partial perception. It is this partial perception that creates the feeling of a previous event. At the time, Sigmund Freud, one of the pioneers of psychology, briefly defined déjà vu as repressed emotions, while Carl Jung linked it to the collective unconscious. Therefore, the difference in these approaches encourage scientists to carry out a series of experiments in order to find some concrete results related to déjà vu, and in 1941, an experiment was carried out, which we call the short-term partial loss of consciousness event. The researchers, Dr. Bannister and Dr. Zangwill, showed their subjects some materials and asked them to observe them carefully. Then, using hypnosis, they induced a state of unconsciousness in the subjects, weakening their memory connections to the materials shown before hypnosis. After a while, the subjects returned to their normal state, and they showed them the materials again and asked them what they remembered about them. 3 out of 10 subjects could not remember where they saw these materials, but said that they did not see them for the first time, and that they experienced déjà vu. In other words, thanks to this experiment, the researchers concluded that artificially induced partial loss of consciousness in humans can cause a feeling of déjà vu afterwards. However, since hypnosis was involved, more ethical and reliable experiments had to be done, so the next experiment was the virtual reality experiment, which is considered the closest to the subject of the Matrix movie.
Déjà vu is generally defined as a feeling of having experienced the current situation before, despite realizing that this is actually new.
Let's look at the details of the experiments he and his team conducted to better understand this definition, which Dr. Cleary also said. The experiments use virtual reality devices that show subjects specially designed realistic spaces. After visiting these spaces for a while, the subjects would visit other spaces with the same general outline, but completely different interior design. For example, look carefully at this picture. This is a bedroom, but in another picture we see a completely different place, a clothing store. The only thing that is the same is the general outline of the spaces. This alone is enough to give the subjects a sense of déjà vu, and many of them report that they did indeed experience déjà vu during the experiment. Of course, the experiment doesn't end there. After the subjects who had visited that bedroom at first were shown many different places, they were shown the same bedroom again towards the end. The interesting thing is that some of these people forget that they saw it in the first place, and when they see it for the second time, they say that they experience a sense of déjà vu more than others. The human brain is very strange, isn't it? All this aside, as I said at the beginning of the video, some people say not only that the event happened again, but also that they know what will happen next. So what about that? To know the answer to this question, we need to look at what happens in the final phase of the experiment. In this phase, special routes are created for the subjects to walk through the rooms, and they are videotaped walking these routes. After several repeated walks, the recorded video is stopped at the last turn of the route, and the subjects are asked to at least guess where they should turn. And although they say they know the next step, interestingly, none of them can even guess the correct route. In other words, the experiment proves that a person's sense of prophecy during déjà vu is a complete illusion. In the scientific world, this is called the déjà vu illusion. All these experiments were done with the help of virtual reality, and similar places were designed in an easy way. In real life, we don't always visit such similar places. Even when we talk about different topics in the same place, there are moments when I have this feeling. But what is the reason for this? This is where we need to know that our brains are not perfect. In other words, some mistakes that our brain makes while encoding and keeping memories in memory may cause déjà vu in a similar memory. Such errors in the memory part are called cryptic loss of consciousness or cryptonism. For example, in any person who experiences this, a large part of the memory in the memory is deleted. But since it is not completely deleted, the missing parts continue to be preserved in the brain. Then when you experience a situation similar to that memory, you try to remember the old deleted memory again, and since the memories are not the same but similar, you get the feeling of déjà vu. If we add the dream memories that the brain does not completely forget, and if these memories coincidentally resemble the memories experienced in real life, it is still possible to experience déjà vu. Another common explanation put forward by scientists is that déjà vu is caused by microsecond differences in the speed of data processing between the brain lobes. When we encounter data, both lobes of our brain process it. However, the sorting of incoming data is done in the left lobe. Normally, the brain corrects the time difference between incoming signals. That is, it synchronizes them. But when it can't do this precisely, the signals are out of sync, which can create the perception of déjà vu. But Dr. Michio Kaku, a Japanese-American theoretical physicist, science writer, and popular science speaker, asks such a question.
Is it ever possible, on any scale, to perhaps flit between different universes?
Some physicists believe that there are multiple universes even in the same room we are in, and that in quantum physics, our atoms can vibrate at the same frequency as these universes from time to time. For example, when we listen to the radio, there are many different frequencies of different channels in the room, but we can listen to only one of them by selecting any frequency, not two at the same time. The relationship between humans and the multiverse is similar to this. When our frequency vibrates in one universe, we cannot interfere with the other universe, just as we cannot listen to two radio channels at the same time. Some theoretical physicists, such as Dr. Michio Kaku, say that our atoms are no longer in sync with those universes, and this is what he says about déjà vu.
Déjà vu is probably simply a fragment of our brain eliciting memories and fragments of previous situations.
Finally, the sensations that mislead us in this way are not just called déjà vu. There are names for many different situations like this. For example, jamais vu is when we feel as if we are experiencing for the first time a situation we know we have encountered before, or déjà vu is the feeling that an event will happen again in the future. Although these are not researched as much as déjà vu, for now, we cannot say that this is 100% of what happens in déjà vu. So what do you think? How do you react when you experience this feeling? It's
like a merry-go-round that never ends, spinning in circles, driving me